At the end of the 19th century, exactly several years after the opening of the Suez Canal, a large ship, coming from India, anchored on the shore of the canal, and on board this ship was a Belgian millionaire named Edward Empin. Edward Empin bore the title of Baron, which was granted to him by the King of France in recognition of his efforts in constructing the Paris Metro, where Empin was a distinguished engineer. And as Edward Empin was an engineer, he was also a person with an exceptional economic mind. He returned to his country and set up several projects that brought him a lot of money, and the head of those projects was the Brussels Bank in Belgium. Edward Empin's only hobby was not collecting money. He loved to travel and traveled constantly, so he set out with his countless money to most countries of the world. He flew to Mexico and from there to Brazil, and from South America to Africa, where he set up many projects in the Congo and achieved great wealth, and from the heart of the Brown Continent, head east to the country of magic and beauty, India. Belgian millionaire and fell in love with the East. Edward Empin lived for many years in India and loved ancient myths, until his decision to search for an older historical place, and he found in front of him only the cradle of ancient civilizations. Egypt. Baron Empin arrived in Cairo, and it was not days before the arrow of love shot up in the heart of the Belgian millionaire. The man loved Egypt to the point of madness, and made a fateful decision to stay in Egypt until his death, and he wrote in his will that he be buried in the soil of Egypt even if he passed away outside it. It was natural for those who made such a decision to search for a permanent residence for them in the place that fell apart from his whims. The strangest thing was the choice of Baron Empin for a place in the desert near Cairo. The Baron chose this place because it is adjacent to Cairo and close to Suez, and that the place enjoys the purity of the air and the purity of the air. And certainly, no one at this time saw what the Belgian economist saw and did not know what was going on in his head about the future. The palace. As soon as the Belgian millionaire chose the place to live in, which is the desert road east of Cairo, Baron Empin worked on studying the architectural style that he would build his house in Cairo, and, because the Baron was also interested in the art of architecture, he made a decision to build a palace like no other in the world. All of which. However, the choice of the architectural style remained a problem that troubled the Baron until he found his desired way in one of the art galleries in the French capital. In this exhibition, his eyes fell on a design for a very magnificent palace created by a French artist named Alexandre Marcel. The design was very attractive and was a wonderful mixture between European architecture and Indian architecture. Thoroughbred Baron. The Baron recalled that during his stay in India, when he suffered from a severe illness that almost killed him, the Indians took care of him, took care of his health, and saved him from certain death. Baron Empin remembered the decision he made in his days after his recovery to build his first new palaces in the Indian style, in gratitude to the people of this country. Baron Edward Empin did not hesitate for a moment. He bought the design from Marcel and took it back to Cairo and handed over the design to a number of Italian and Belgian engineers to start building the palace on the high hill that the Baron had set for them in the Cairo desert. After 5 years, the architectural masterpiece emerged from the desert. A magnificent palace whose balconies were beautified with marble statues in the form of elephants, and it has a tower that rotates on a moving base, one full rotation every hour to allow the seated in it to see what is around him in all directions. The palace consists of two floors and a small extension near it topped with a large dome, and on the walls of the palace there are wonderful marble statues of dancers from India and elephants to raise the windows studded with small pieces of Belgian glass, knights carrying swords and mythical animals leaning on the walls of the palace. It is striking that the palace was built so that the sun never sets. Night ghosts. Most of the rumors that made the Baron's Palace the real home of terror revolve around hearing voices. To move the palace is foundation between its different rooms in the middle of the night, and the lights that suddenly light up in the backyard of the palace and suddenly turn off as well. Facing the palace, that ghosts do not appear in the palace except at night, and it does not allow anyone to remain inside the palace at any cost. He continues, saying, "What is said about the existence of ghosts is true, which confirms that what happened in the year 82, when many passers-by saw smoke emanating from the main palace room and then entered the window of the main tower of the palace, after which a glow of fire appeared, which soon went out alone, without working nobody to put it off. Why?" This question remains open to everyone who has heard of the Baron's Palace and the rumors spreading about it. Why is this particular building? Perhaps the Baron's miserable life is one of the main reasons that have fueled the stories of spirits that have been passed on for 100 years. Baron Empin was born with a visible limp in his feet, in addition to being ill with epilepsy. He often had epileptic seizures, so he fell in the garden of his palace and the sun shone upon him, and his dog stood next to him until he woke up. Because of his extreme rigor, no servant could approach him without his command, even if he's lying unconscious on the ground. But this is about the Baron, so what about the palace? The Enchanted Room. The reason for the ambiguity surrounding the house is that there is a room in the palace that Baron Empin denied entry to even his daughter and sister Baroness Helena, which is the pink room in the basement of the palace, and this room opens its doors to the entrance to the long basement extending to the basilica in which the Baron was buried after his death. Sister Baron. One of the reasons that increased the ambiguity was the killing of the sister of the Baron, Baroness Helena, after she fell from the balcony of her inner room while the Baron was going around the palace tower to the south, and the base stopped rotating at that moment after the Baron rushed to find his sister's cries, and these were it is the first spark of ghost stories that emerged from the Baron's sister's room into his personal room. This made popular stories indicate that the spirit of Baroness Helena was indignant at the Baron's delay in saving her, which disrupted the rotating gears of the rotating tower that did not rotate since then until the death of the Baron himself in 1928. While she was also, according to the rumors, different voices were heard, some of them quarrels, and some of them screaming by the Baron and his sister, who had already died and buried her body somewhere in the Heliopolis desert. Since then, the old people of the Heliopolis neighborhood believe that Baron Empin had succeeded after the death of his sister in preparing her soul to apologize for not taking the initiative to quickly save her after falling from her room, and perhaps not accepting his sister's spirit. The apology is what brought him into a depressive phase that ultimately led to his death. Mystery has a price. During the past 30 years, the interests of many adventurers in the palace building increased, and some of them preferred to hold barbecues at the top of its tower that was once revolving, so the history of the palace, unlike any other building in Cairo, was linked to many circumstances that added an aura of excitement and mystery, and perhaps this explains why more than one book appeared on the market dealing with the story of the ghost mansion owned by Baron Empin. It also explains the continuous attempts by foreign artistic production companies to offer huge sums of money to enter it and shoot some scenes of their films at home. The most interesting thing is that most of what foreign companies asked to shoot inside the palace were horror scenes for films that closely resemble Count Dracula and Vampire, which indicates that the Palace of Horror story was not limited to Egyptians only, but spread to the whole world.